So in my original 2014 video, my top five was, and to quote,
number five, Ben Frost's Aurora. Number four, Aphex Twin's Syro. Number three, A Sunny Day in Glasgow, See You When Absent. Number two, Run the Jewels 2. Number one, Swans to Be Kind.
And I think it's best for me to redo this list to the best of my abilities now that it's been almost 5 years since that video. Number five would probably have to be German Error Message Haunts, which, understandably, it's a lo-fi indie album. I'm not really that big on Bandcamp era lo-fi indie stuff. That's just not my thing. People who know me know that I'm not that big on guys like Alex G or Car Seat Headrest or Frankie Cosmos, because that stuff just, it's not for me. I don't listen to that stuff regularly. But I do like Haunts because, and this may sound like a critique for some, but for me, it's why I like it. It's a bit derivative and it's a poor man's version of the Glow Part 2, of the Microphones. It does sound a bit like that, but I mean, honestly, that's why I enjoy it. It's a comfy sounding album. It's just a wonderful little lo-fi bedroom folk album. Number four, I think to retain one album from the previous list would be To Be Kind by Swans. Now, I do think it's a strong and good album, but I do think it's overrated in some regards. I think the fact that people consider it to be the best Swans album is fine in its own subjective right, but as someone whose favorite Swans albums are soundtracks and Seer, I consider Swans' best efforts to be albums that showcase a diverse range of style and influence, and I'm not saying that To Be Kind doesn't do that, but it doesn't do it to an extent compared to the Seer and, you know, the hodgepodge of cuts, sketches, and ideas within Soundtracks for the Blind. The majority of To Be Kind's two-hour-long runtime, for me anyway, sounds like a rather giant, anthemic, balls-to-the-walls noise rock album, you know, which, you know, of course, is still a pretty good thing in its own right. I know that's fine by all means, and, you know, I still think it's one of the best albums of 2014. I wouldn't consider it to be the best album of 2014, let alone the best Swans album ever in their entire lengthy, long career. Now, number three, End On Mama. If you enjoy giant, balls-to-the-walls noise rock shit, then Mama by End On is amazing. It is chaotic, it is raw to the fucking core. It is amazing. It's fucking crazy. I love it, I love it, I love it. Number two would probably be Travel by Jun Konagaya. Konagaya, or Grimm, whatever people, you know, look at him, long-time Japanese experimental electronic musician, power electronics, and folky bullshit. He rather eclectic styles and influences coming from him. In this album in particular, it has a very consistent, creepy, dark atmosphere to it, while also showcasing a wide variety of styles and influences, ranging from dark industrial-esque ambient music to elements of psychedelic and avant folk that will appear every once in a while in his like older like 80s Grimm releases, which I really enjoy. You know, what I love about Konagaya is that he has this it's just he's all over the place with his stuff. I think of it as vital music that just has like a few songs that's just pure psychedelic folk, and then the rest is just power electronics bullshit. So yeah, Travel by Jun Konagaya is definitely number two. And number one for me would probably be Winter Schwarze by Jotgrim. An amazing lo-fi-esque, atmospheric, spacey, dark, cold dungeon synth album from the Voltsum, which holds a lot of that particular style of dungeon synth, where it's all just low fidelity, atmospheric, cold sounding ambient music. This is just an amazing, immersive, atmospheric, relaxing album. I'm just completely blown away by its beauty, I guess is the best way to describe it. yeah, I mean, overall, it's just an absolutely amazing album. You know, what I can say about any Dungeon Synth album that I enjoy is the same thing I can say for everything else that I like within the genre, is that it's atmospheric and it's immersive. Some albums do it really, really well, some albums do it not so well, and this is an album that does it really, really, really fucking well. So yeah, I guess that would be my top 5. Haunts, To Be Kind, Mama, Travel, Wintersforza.